Hey everyone, Brian here. Today I'll be talking to you guys about espresso and coffee scales. First of all, I'll be going over the Gdealer, then the Timemore Black Mirror, and then finally the Acaia Lunar. I'll be going over the pros and cons of each of these scales, as well as some final thoughts on use cases, as well as some quirks and interesting nitpicks and features that I've found over my experience of using these scales. Feel free to join me in the Espresso Discord, link in the description below, and of course, subscribe to the channel for more videos. All right, let's talk Gdealer basic $10, $15 Amazon scale. Why is this such a good scale, and why do most of us have this scale? Well, it's really cheap, but also it's accurate and it is a small scale. If this scale can fit into almost every single machine, it has really easy functions. There's just basically only two functions you need to just turn on and tare. And it also weighs incredibly accurate. It's just as accurate as my Lunar or other high-end scales. And not to mention, it's small and it uses AAA batteries. There's no recharging here. You just swap your batteries out and you're good to go. And one thing that we should talk about though are, what are the problems with a cheaper end scale or a lower end scale like this? One thing to note is, of course, the build quality. You definitely don't want to get this guy very wet. You want to make sure it's clean all the time. If you've messed up your shots when you're pulling, you run the risk of really killing these scales. However, the fact that it's a pretty cheap scale really makes up for a lot of this. Another con or a thing I feel like people don't talk about that much is weighing on a scale this small. Say, for example, I have a portafilter here. If I wanted to just only weigh on the scale, you'll notice how the portafilter kind of sits lopsided. It's really hard to actually make sure this guy sits properly. And imagine having dosed 18 grams in here and you've put it on here and your coffee just falls out. That's happened to me a few times. So to solve that, what I would recommend is you 3D print a little stand like so. This will then let you stick your portafilter on and you'll be able to weigh. Keep in mind, if you do have a heavier portafilter that's over 500 grams, I think the Gdealer Classic Pro stock portafilter already weighs about 500 grams. You might feel like you're screwed, but this is an interesting quirk about the scale. This scale will actually let you go above 500 grams if you turn the scale off and you set your things on top and then you turn it on. It'll actually let you go up to about 670, 700 grams. So that's an interesting thing, because then that means you can use heavier cups like the not neutral Vero cups. You can now actually get away with doing a full-size Chemex and brewing one cup in that. So to wrap up, obviously this is a really cheap scale, but it's really accurate. It's really good. However, it is slightly slower than other scales. And also keep in mind that you need to be careful when you use this guy. You can run the risk of killing it if it gets too wet. However, I think the pros outweigh the cons in this case. This is such a cheap scale, and it actually has all these additional features that you don't think about. If you do work around the size of the scale, you think you're fine. You're good to go. Okay, Timemore Black Mirror. This guy comes in at about $70, and as you notice, hopefully, is the size. Look at how big this guy is. I remember seeing a lot of people talking about how this would be the new Acaia Lunar killer, or basically you could get every feature that the Lunar has for a lot less. Here I have the basic model, which is $70, as I mentioned. It has, I think, one weight sensor, and it doesn't have any smart features besides the fact that it has a really cool display that turns on like so. You just run your finger over the bottom right-hand corner. And then it also has sound, so now you can hear things when you are tearing or when you're resetting your timer. Also timing function. But one really nice thing and cool thing is USB-C charging. Out of all the newer scales, this is probably one of the few that has USB-C charging. Another thing to note on that USB-C charging is that it charges really, really fast. It also has really great battery life. Good features for a scale for $70. And all these are pros in the sense of if you use this guy as a dosing scale, you can now fit larger portafilters on here without a problem. You can use a portafilter stand, always, which always helps. But let's go over some cons of the scale. Well, one thing is the size. If you're trying to use this for brewing purposes, not a lot of machines can fit something this big and also have clearance for cups, unless you have like bottomless portafilter and lower custom drip tray. So that could be a problem. However, you totally can use this on something like a Gadget Classic Pro. It turns out if you just turn this guy around, you can fit it on the Gadget Classic Pro easily. And that's a machine that's notorious for having drip tray size problems. What are some other cons of this scale? One thing is I don't believe there's an easy way to calibrate it, but also maybe my unit has had this problem, but I think if you look at how flexible this chassis is, you can see how it's flexing. I feel like this sometimes is what's throwing off readings. Sometimes when I have a very accurate 18 gram dose on here and I bump this table, for example, or I bump my scale just a little bit, it throws off the readings just slightly. And the reading sometimes sticks, so that's a little bit annoying. But otherwise, I think it's because of how big the scale is and with the flex. But otherwise, I think this is an incredibly good scale for the money. You can't really go wrong with it. However, if you're using it for brewing purposes, I think you should look at cheaper scales like the Gdealer or look up at like a Acaia Lunar. For dosing, perfect scale for dosing. For pour overs, really convenient because you have the built-in timer for that one. Okay, Acaia Lunar, $225, comes in silver, comes in black, really, really nice scale. The main conclusion of this scale is that it's just an incredibly beginner-friendly scale because it does everything for you. It tares for you, it times for you, it detects when espresso comes, or when you're brewing. It's got app connectivity, it's got it all. A scale that everyone seems to want, but obviously spending $200 on a scale is kind of scary, and I'll talk about why it's scary real soon. First of all, let's look at the design of the scale. Really nice, it's kind of like an Apple MacBook design, MacBook Pro design for your scale. It comes with different feet, so if you want something that slides or sticks like this one, it lets you do that. You can choose micro USB charging, which is a little bit annoying, but otherwise, really responsive scale. It's so fast. What is the downside of this scale? Well, it does have the same problems with dosing because of its physical size. If you use a portafilter, you want to make sure you have a stand, or you can buy Acaia's for a lot of money. If I use this as my only scale, I use this even with the stand for dosing and brewing, having to move this scale from my counter or this table to my machine's drip tray is actually incredibly scary, and it's really an issue that only I found with this scale. And why is that? Well, because of how the scale is designed, maybe because I have the silver model of the Lunar, it is really slippery. And also because it's a heavy scale, when you move it, you run the risk of dropping this guy. And I don't really like the idea of dropping a $220 scale or $250 scale, even though it's maybe a 1 to 2 inch drop. That's not a really fun idea. And that's one thing that I think a lot of people overlook is, wow, I didn't realize this guy was this heavy and this slippery. And maybe I'm nitpicking this way because this is such a great scale in every other aspect, but I thought this was a valid concern to raise. There are definitely a lot of handful of issues with support and non-replaceable batteries, but besides that, I think this is an incredibly good scale. Okay, now that we have gone over all of these scales, let's talk about use cases. What would be a really good use case for each of these scales? If you only had to choose one, I think the Lunar is the one to get. However, if you didn't want to spend 200 something bucks, Gdealer is really good. In fact, if you get two Gdealers, I think you're set. Black Mirror is not really for espresso. I think if you use the Black Mirror, you do need a smaller scale. However, if you don't even drink espresso, this is fine for everything. Now, let's talk about dual scale setups. I think that's really interesting. If you had two Gdealer scales, you would be set. You would be able to get everything except for timing. Now, if you had a combination of the Black Mirror and Gdealer, you essentially get every single feature of the Lunar without the with the convenience of having two different scales, and you don't have to move scales around. The ideal setup of these is obviously a Lunar and Black Mirror. This is what I personally use. I dose on the Black Mirror, and then I brew in with the Lunar. Another addition that's really nice is the fact that the Lunar is Bluetooth connected. So for those of you who own the decent DE1, you can hook your Lunar up to this guy, and all you have to do is turn this guy on, and you essentially don't even have to touch a scale at all when you brew. So that's another really nice thing. Now let's real quick touch upon speeds of these scales, because I sort of glossed over it earlier. Speeds of these scales is kind of important because it's like your lag time between the amount of espresso you have versus when you stopped a shot. This is obviously the slowest of them. I feel like these two are about on par with speed. However, I think the way that this display refreshes compared to this one is slightly better. The numbers in the way it increases seem to just be slightly more fluid. I don't know if you can see that, but I'll have a close-up shot of this. It just seems to be slightly more fluid in how the numbers increase than this one. And that could also be said the same about the Gdealer here, is that I think these LCD displays here seem to be better than this under plastic LCD display, in that the numbers here are really, really fast to, or like they are more more incremental numbers. However, this is the slowest of all three of these scales. But that is something to keep in mind, is that if you're aiming for pure accuracy, this one updates at a more, I think, a faster rate than this one here, if you're just looking at numbers specifically. So that's something to keep in mind if you're a stickler for that. However, I don't know if you could even taste the difference between like a 0.1 gram, but with this guy, if you're off by a second, you could be off by 1 or 2 grams. So keep that in mind. But with these guys, you're fine. If you can fit this guy, I totally would recommend him. But honestly, this is the way to go if you really want the best setup for the money, I feel like. Well, for the higher end stuff, I would personally pick the Black Mirror over the Pearl. I used the Pearl before. I'm not really a big fan of it. I just think the Black Mirror looks better, and also the basic model is so much easier to use than all these smart features that you probably aren't even going to ever use on the Lunar. You're probably just going to keep it in one mode, and you're going to just keep it at that mode forever. So anyway, to wrap up, I think if you just have a scale at all that can do 0.1 grams, that can weigh your portafilters and do your dosing, I think you're fine in this, as long as you keep in mind of the time of your brewing and you keep in mind your weight, you should be good to go. What you do get when you spend more money in the world of scales is features. You get the better convenience factor of having a built-in timer, the rechargeable batteries, and then also the smart connectivity and higher build quality. But otherwise, I think this guy would work for everything else. These guys, if you want to spend more money. Thanks for watching, and please follow my channel. I'll be taking a look at profiling on the decent, dialing in really on the decent DE1 soon. And then I'll be going over a comparison video of the Gotcha Classic Pro and the decent DE1 Pro. So stick around.